Remy and Daniel laughed. The treasure hunter looked hurt.
What?
Nothing. Private joke. Go on.
The ship was called Extremadura. She sailed from the coast of Colombia in 1612 with a huge collection of gold from the mines there. Then she got caught in a storm and lost at sea. People have been searching for it ever since. There's a fortune on board.
And that's what you've been doing every day? Remy asked. Going out and looking for it?
Yes.
Just yourself?
I found some new evidence, some clues in an old Spanish archive that hint that it was wrecked near this island, and none in very deep water either. There have been reports of Spanish coins being found on the beaches here. Some people say it's because of the fort nearby. This island was owned by Spain for a long time, after all. But I think the tides have washed coins onto the beach from this wreck. I've seen it before. The action of the water will take lighter artifacts off the top surfaces of a wreck and spread them around, but the items in the lower hold, where the main treasure would have been stored, should be intact.
So, why come to us? Daniel asked.
George Devon smiled.
Because something struck me as strange about you. Your historical knowledge, your situational awareness, your shoulder holster. That jogged a memory of something I read. So I did some digging.
He pointed to Remy and then to Daniel.
You're Remy Laurent and you're Daniel Walker. You are the dynamic duo of treasure hunters.
Remy stiffened. He had hidden that so well. This extrovert had fooled the two FBI agents into a false sense of security. Daniel frowned at him.
If you're such a good detective, you should have also find out we're with the FBI.
The waiter chose that moment to make his appearance. He served the drinks in record time and vanished. George Devon smiled.
Sure, I know you're FBI. No problem with that. I'm a patriotic American. But you're on vacation now, am I right?
Yes, Remy said. We want to get away from all that.